This meeting is being recorded. That's so funny.
I love that opening. Yeah. This meeting is being recorded, and here we are.
Yeah, and I will have to listen to it to listen if they broadcast it already. This meeting is being recorded, and then it's already starting. So I'm not sure yet. So I have to do that. Okay, we were talking a bit about what kind of topic we wanted to talk about today. And a lot of things passed, and some of the things were about that a lot of, and that there's a buildup of energy constantly, and people are talking about maybe a big boom in energy in June or July or August or whatever. And then we discussed that but it's constantly a huge energy. And if you compare it to last year or something like that, half a year or a year ago, it's enormous. Yeah. And that makes everything a bit more powerful, strengthened, more pressure. So and in the end, we came to the conclusion that it would be helpful to help everybody who's listening to this with codes for keeping your strengths, keeping your faith, being sovereign to your own beliefs, to your heart. All these things, touching the things around being centralized in your heart, in whatever situation, with outside pressure, with governmental pressure, or any pressure at all, doesn't matter. There's always a good reason to give in and to say, I'm fed up with it. But the main thing, that's really for me, and I think for Inger as well, is that if you stay in your own truth and in your own sovereignty and in your own power of your heart, then everything will be much easier.
Yeah.
And so what we're going to do is to clear some energies, and then we're going to give you some codes and work on this being centered. So let's do that. Let's state that everything is done for the highest good, for the highest light, all from the centered heart, from Inger and from me. We are only trying to support you, help you, so that we are in a wider group, more people or beings doing the things for the light. Shall I open with some codes to clear?
Yeah, do that. So I will come in.
Okay. So I will clear the energies so that we are only working for the highest good, the highest light. All people listening to this for now and in the future, that we are helping this energy to be as beautiful as possible. Shur udana shi ti ko to yo to ko to ta ta ti ti shkut. Shur na'i nanyana da'i atai shut orototish nr atai ndr andash ot nar shutotita katatitir urodor ndarai shirandara rshtokototish tatai nandarai nyan yan 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 yan
That was really cleaning the house, Robert. and I got connected to the galactics. So I'm going to bring in some galactic energies and see.
Yes,
Kaino yo ketemena agia koton shania kakio akana mania tatai ono shoni kio toto manini na koyo koto toto 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 That was actually more coming online from our own individual galactic part. It's like an opening up where we all became more connected and kind of, in a way, I will call it overshadowed by our galactic self. And they came online just because they will be a very strong part of this session we are going to do today, whatever and however it will unfold. There is a very, very strong galactic backup. Also because we have to learn to be more galactic, to constantly bring that energy in and understand that we are at a place and a space in our history where galactic is going mainstream. And when we do that, there's a huge opening and connection to the heart so that we really learn to, in every shape or form, work through the heart for the highest good of all and everything.
Okay.
And every person will kind of be connected to their level or intensity of this galactic energy that is them, to the degree that is comfortable for their bodies. So this will not be any overload, but it will just be more a feeling of coming home.
Mm.
Yeah.
So then with this galactic information, we can combine the codes we were preparing by talking about. So what I'm going to do is to mix up some codes for everybody who's listening to this, and combined, of course, with this galactic support, that we want to keep up the faith and keep up the faith that that's what we, in which we mean that we want to be centered in our heart, that our energy is love and light, and that we are aware of our sovereign being, that we are aware that we can, if we are open and truthfully and pure, that we can stand tall in our inner truth. And with the connection in our heart, we feel the faith, we feel the support of the galactic, we feel the support of all beings, we feel the support of the central sun and the source.
The first I noticed when you started was that you open like a diamond doorway, above a diamond doorway, above, like that, like,
yeah.
Not that one. Yeah. And there was a lot of energy coming down that was kind of clearing and clearing. It was like sometimes where there are patterns in our field, they can look like a machinery that is kind of stuck because something is hooked up and something is come in between so that the wheels can turn as they're supposed to. So it was like clearing that old geometry and the way the wheels within wheels kind of spin in the field. And then there was a beautiful combination of pink and apple green with a beautiful violet beam coming down. And the message was like, we are now supporting you to stand in the beam. No matter what you are going through in the future, you can connect to this moment in time when Robert opened that and connect to that energy and stand in your beam, and you will be mainly and greatly supported. And I know that from my own experience with working with energies is that many times we can have breakthroughs. And I know a lot of people actually have had breakthroughs in May. Like when a dam broke and suddenly you get an understanding, or you get a connection with more of you, or something just that releases so tremendously from your space that you actually feel like a completely different, a new being. The first days in this space can feel kind of vulnerable. Like I used to say, I feel like I don't have any skin.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, also as this shown, standing in the beam is a very, very supportive energy because it holds you. Because one thing I noticed also is that, as we talked, you mentioned, there's a lot of pressure. There's a lot of inner pressure to break through. And there's a lot of outer pressure to get you down and stay, you know?
Yeah.
And to be kind of squeezed in the middle of all of this for the humanness is not an easy situation. So when you have something like that, where you actually can stand solid, I stand in my beam. No matter what, I'm in my beam. No matter what, I'm here. It's a very, very helpful tool. So that was absolutely beautiful. Perfect.
Yeah.
Mm, goody, Robert. Yeah.
Okay. And do the galactics have something supporting in this? Because the beam came from them.
The beam, comes from, it's like a portal that opened in us, for us, which is deeply connected to our galactic part, because the galactic part, I think, is those who kind of helps us open and support that part of us. It's not something you can kind of open without having access energetically to it. But what I know is that even when we do something, it's not always that people exactly feel it.
Yeah.
Or people feel it in a very different way because we're not alike.
Yeah, all unique.
Yeah. So even though if you didn't feel the beam, you can still call upon it because it's there.
Mm.
We all feel it differently. So it's like, I'm in my beam.
Sounds like a nice African name, Amama Beam.
I'm in my beam, standing tall.
So,
and it's like no one can knock you out from that place because you're so grounded and deeply present within yourself when you're that. You're like tall.
Yeah.
Really standing tall, yeah.
And that's funny because I was writing down some new quotes, ideas. But by writing them down and thinking about it and listening to you, I was like, there are so many things we took in the past from outside,
yeah.
And made it our own belief systems.
Mm.
So maybe it's a good idea to clear a bit from the inside out, from old belief systems being programmed in our systems, so that we have more space to be in our beam. And let's have a try on that. So it's not every belief system is wrong or right, but the clearing for this code will bring is the clearing from the inside, from the heart center,
yeah,
to clear everything or filter it all through the heart.
I so agree with you, because this is what you talked a little bit about before, when it comes to the understanding that we are actually playing a game, but you can't win a game. A lot of people are referring to, oh, they lost the game, or they won the game, or whatever. Light has won, the darkness have lost, and everything. Nothing wins anything. You step out of it. As long as you're in the place where you think something wins or something loses, you're coming from duality.
Yeah.
When you step out of it, you are in a completely different space, where winning and losing are words that have absolutely no meaning at all.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you said there to also bring in the support, that it's easier for us to step out when we feel that situations want to, or people we attract, try to bring us more in.
Okay, let's have a go.
Yeah, I love that one.
So in all times and space, in all your lifetimes, and with the collective beam activated, we gonna let all programs, thoughts, ideas from all time and space brought into your system being filtered again through your heart center to the photon, which is your connection with the inner, your higher self, with the central sun, the source. And that will filter all these belief systems brought into your system so that your system will be cleaned and cleared from the inside out.
This one's so perfect because it built upon the call you delivered earlier with the faith, having faith in things, because it was like, it was strengthening the being to believing that I can take my feet out of this quagmire. It's like, almost like you've been walking in a quagmire or in glue, and suddenly it loosens and you can, the trust is there, I can open. And at the same time, it was like a whirlwind. While coming down, that kind of was spinning and spinning and spinning and spinning. And I felt that it was widening the field. When it was widened, it felt like it was being, in a way, woven into a grander reality.
Yeah.
But not in this way when we talk about weaving something into something, that it kind of gets stuck.
Yeah.
It's to be, it felt like it was to be part of a flow, a very supportive field of resonance. And everything is coming from the heart, so it's like the feeling of support was immense in it. Just like when you enter a new space and where do I go, what do you do, and there is immediately appearing energies and support around you from the most amazing places and in ways you never could have dreamt of. And it's like that. I said wow.
Yeah.
And in that energy is something that I've seen coming a lot, and that we've been talking a lot about with other friends. The need to restore what has been sacred. And I want to bring in some energy on this. I just want people to hold their heart and feel into the energy of being of sacredness, and then I'll see what comes.
Yeah.
Shiokona a ilkotanya mana a kiokotana shianakai anamatini kiakatata ashana mana yeko ashana yokotana a mionoko sha ayo initoyo amayana Initoyo amayana ashanekiyo ai ashanekiyo ai am anaiaka ashatai keneme e anakatoi ieneka ashanamaniyo ashanamanai keokotene etiamana shana ashakiokotoi katio. The images I was given was like huge diamond crystalline energy coming in like this to the heart, and the heart became like a diamond doorway, and then it was sending the same energy down, and then it was like glittering threads of crystalline diamond light coming in. When it came to the heart, it was kind of something happened. I can't explain it, but it was like something in energy that shifted it and kind of sent it down. It's not always that you can take energy from there and straight down. Sometimes it has to be come through something that can make it possible to send it deeper down.
Yeah.
And you said it was the reconnection. And they were very, very happy, and because what came in with them was the elves, the Elver Kingdom, the fairies, the unicorns, you know, that realm, which many of us connects to the feeling of being sacred, the sacredness, the sacredness with nature, this beautiful, tiny, clear, very raw and honest, and all encompassing energy. And then it was kind of flooded down as energetic patterns into this realm. And it's like, it's so important to connect to nature, to all the elements, to the elves, elver heart, all the different kingdoms, and to sit together in that energy, in that frequency of the sacred meetings that we used to have and the sacred space that we have together. And even calling the dragons, there are extremely beautiful sacred dragons that now are starting to connect again for the first time, because the energy here hasn't been high enough to support their connection. So there are so much that is kind of opening up to be experienced. And it's all about coming together in the heart and but restoring that.
By coming together, I would like to do some quotes on, I make a combination of them, two of them, things you were saying. So what I'm going to do is an old time and space for everybody who has the allowance for it, to recollect, to regather all soul parts, to bring them back into the center of your heart, to open the heart, to be able to the highest, to allow of the highest light, to reconnect to all of the highest light, good and energy. Shunyaika, shinanai shuku, otayanai shita, Shati ku ku chi ji yana shu to yatai shi ura shanai ku ku yana shai yana yano to yatai yana yuko to yoto da yana na yano na yano yani yana uchuna na shu na na ishi yawo to yoto yoi ta ya ita yo to
That, first of all, that was not only codes for us, but that was codes for all the kingdoms. They showed up. Mm. It was like I ended up in a council meeting about, you know, the elves and the nature spirits and the animals and everything. Everybody showed up and everybody opened their heart to each other. And there was this exchange or the flow of energy from heart to heart, like connecting again and again. And again, and it expanded, and it expanded, and actually, I want to lay down and cry. It was so beautiful because it was like such a homecoming.
Mm.
And they asked me to bring in one energy, and I will do that, and I will explain after. Amana yaki kokotoyo meniaka ashatene meni ekiakatono mena a ayakotoyo ke yakatana shanemi oyo akio kosha akayamane iokotono meni yakatashta anene menias ayeyo ayakata ya. You might want to put some codes on this too after I've said something here. What they came through and said is that we have been kind of led to believe that the outer appearances meant something. And that when we saw something that was kind of, we've been led to say, oh, that's ugly, that's not nice, they look weird, that creature doesn't look nice, you know, something. There's a part of us that have immediately put up a wall.
Mm-hmm.
And they ask us to take that down and to see things as they truly are. When we meet with each other, when we walk in nature, when we look at the stars, whatever we encounter, make a choice to see things as they truly and really are. Because that is something that will change our reality tremendously.
Okay.
I've seen that so many times, and there is so many twisted experience that comes from twisted learnings about how things are and how they're not, and how the outer appearance can really, really make you into a twisted experience. So really see.
Yeah.
And with that, I don't mean to jump in and not be cautious, because there are still patterns at play. There's still patterns at play that we need to be aware of when we deal with everything. But still, if we can make that connection point on a physical daily level, to meet up and see everything as they truly are, we are empowering them tremendously.
Mm.
And that's what the desire is, yeah.
Okay, well, that sounds easy.
Good. <That's> easy.
No, it's in all time and space, in all lifetimes, in all, we experience things and we've learned and been programmed to have a high value on outer experiences, outer labeling, outer judgments.
Mm.
And what we're going to do in all time and space is to bring back these judgments into the inner values of true love, authenticity, sovereignty, of source made, highest light, highest good, of all kingdoms. And that we don't experience anything in like we used to in the past by the outer world, that we can still use the outer world to have an opinion, but we can filter that through the heart. It always should be filtered by the heart.
No, I'm really blissed out. This is a bliss day. First of all, I saw this clearing that was taking place. And I was surprised of how much it actually was, how much I've been disguised. Mm-hmm. So there was like a lot of clearing and removing. But then it was like someone opened a gate, and in front of me was this huge meadow with the most amazing flowers and things growing and entities of all shapes and forms playing. And there was this deep honoring of the beauty of everybody's growth process, from the tiny, tiny seed that just came a centimeter off the soil, to the ones who were actually fully blown, to those who were bearing fruit, to those who actually was dying and going back to come up and forth in their next expression. It was like there was no judgment. It was just this deep, deep sacred space and honoring of everything you are in every cycle of your existence, you exist in. Absolutely beautiful. Mm. And I had to say, feel, what if we really could manage to live like that all the time? To see everybody with those eyes from that perception and keep reminding us. Because I noticed also with myself that many times their responses on outer appearances, whatever it is so automatic.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then just, why did I think that? Why did I feel that about this and that? And where did it come from? Mm. Mostly, it's not even mine. It's just a part of the
collection. There are many ways this programming is working. And it's, mm. like, it's constantly in all the environments. It's a collective. Mm. Of course, in your younger years, you've been to school and your parents have been teaching you things. And it was all in between the lines.
Yeah.
Plus, just in your face.
Exactly.
And it, and it's okay. And don't, we don't need to be hard on ourselves if we are judgmental. It's beautiful that we are aware of it.
Yeah.
As soon as we are aware of it, we can change it. So, and so you don't blame yourself. Oh, I'm discriminating, or I'm labeling, or I'm doing anything from the past. Because it's now the time to recognize it and to get rid of it and to change it, so that we can be in that state.
Yeah.
And I believe we don't have to hope for it. It will be there. It's just if because your inner world is expressing your outer world. So if your inner world is getting blissed like this, then your outer world will become, and it's just a matter of time. It will change as well.
Exactly. And I'm happy you said it that way, because then I want to share something that my higher self showed me the other day, because there's a lot of talk about, you know, disclosure and chaos coming and stuff like that. And it's very easy to be drawn into this subject. And I've seen a lot of people go into fear and judgment, and there are many, many emotional states around it. And yes, there will be chaos, but it's a good thing. It's not a bad thing, it's a very good thing, she said, because we are bringing in more and more light by being here, by shining, as they keep saying, it's a time to shine. And the more we shine, the more transparent the reality becomes. And when more and more people walk in those fields, they're starting to loosening the grip on their patterns too. And this is happening on a grander and grander scale, and we have wished for this. But when there is a massive opening in the collective, that means that the collective suddenly start to experience their inner distortion outside of them. That spells chaos.
I always loved chaos.
It
gives you playing time. You can try things out. You can, and nobody's paying attention, because there's no, it's a Dutch expression, if you put your head higher than the field, they cut you off. But if there's not cut fields, there's no clear line in it. So you can put your head anywhere, and there's nobody bothering you.
Yeah, that's true. And then you can put your hand on the heart and say, I'm in the beam.
Yeah, which you,
because I'm in the beam.
No, you are in the beam. You are the beam.
I'm the beam. I'm in the beam.
So, and if everybody's just trusting that everything will be okay, and everything is perfectly all right, orchestrated, so that your higher self is not just letting you play around, it's just, it's guiding you, it's helping you to manifest everything which is orchestrated. But the trust in that, the belief in that, which can grow day by day, hour by hour, because if you feel that and you connect to your heart, and you stand in the beam and you are the beam, you know it's true, and it's, and this truth will be growing on a daily basis. So and whatever comes around you, you can say it will be chaos, but I think we have a lot of chaos all around us already for a long time now, not only the last 1.5 years, but many, many years before. So I think this duality planet is a chaos planet. So nothing will be really changed. The only thing what will change is that we start living from the inner world. That's the big change, because we always make believing that the outer world was interesting, and we had our hopes on the outer world, and now it's all twisted around. Now we realize again, okay, yes, but it's us who will make the change. It's us who will make the new planet Earth. It's us who makes everything changing for what is needed.
And when we can stand in a beam and see things as they truly are, it's so much easier.
Yeah.
It's a great tools. I got a dragon coming in with some, I think I feel it goes to my third eye. I'm just going to bring him through.
Dragons are always welcome.
Dragons are dragon energy, yeah. Rumania Kashra. Rumania Kashra. Rumania Kashra. Ammanai, ammanai, ammanai. Shimashitai koto, shimashitai koto, shimashitai koto. Pashmatu emani, pashmatu emani, pashmatu emani. I thought I went completely galactic. It actually felt like I was a galaxy. My entire third eye was a galaxy. It was huge and it was kind of moving a bit, so I just had to sit with that. I'm online. Yeah. So it was bringing or making available more of our galactic consciousness.
Mm. Beautiful. So we got the galactic third eye and the galactic beam.
Yeah.
And that should help everybody.
Yeah. And stay. I so love the thing that you did with seeing things, choosing to see things as they truly are. Because we need to kind of strip down to the core.
Yeah.
So I love these components.
Yeah, and sometimes it's easy and sometimes it's hard, but whatever it is, after you did it, it's always better.
Make a choice.
Yeah. And and even if you made a choice which is different from others, as long as your sovereign choice, whatever that will be, it's okay.
Yeah.
Because we are all unique, we all have a different paths and different missions, or however you want to call it.
Yeah.
So there's only a duality. There's good and bad choices. Mm-hmm. So in our new world, everything is okay.
Yes, all is well in all of creation.
Yeah.
All is well in all of creation. At least these energies have made me glow. I feel like I'm
spaced out.
I'm really, really warm. Really, really warm.
Yeah. I got a buzzing head.
Yeah. Do we need a little bit grounding on this?
No.
It's okay.
Yeah, but good. We need a blessing.
We need a blessing. Okay, we'll get the blessing. Yay! Let's bring in the trees then. Iono komia, iono koya, akio kominia tiata, ashai emenia, eshia kotoi, emeni iono, emeni ionoi, ekio kotoyo, ekia keta, shanamania, shanamana, matia, matia, matia. And the message is just remember, the root is in your heart.
Beautiful.
And that energy of the heart sustains every part of your being. Mm. You grow from there. Yeah.
And I felt that I was really strict on the no of grounding. But it doesn't mean that some people who are listening to this are feeling the need to be grounded or need and maybe need some help. So you can always, if you need some assistance, some help, somebody to talk to, you can always contact Inger or myself. Mm. Don't hesitate in that. Don't try to work out your things if you're stuck. Mm. So the grounding is more for me and Inger, my reaction was. And because I believe that this beam and this all this galactic work is needs to be on a higher space, and we are grounding it by being here and standing here in our own authenticity. Mm. But if for somebody who's listening to it, it's different. So don't hesitate to contact us.
The easiest thing to do there is just ask the beam to ground in your Earth star. And it will click into position and hold you. Yeah.
Yeah. So, and if that doesn't work, or if you don't believe it works or don't feel like it, just contact Inger, contact myself. Yeah. If you got any questions on these topics, we are gladly to help you.
Yeah.
We are way showers. So we show you the way how to do your inner work. We can give you assistance in that, but we don't overtake your own inner work. So I hope everybody likes it. I really did like this one. It's really powerful, and I love it when the galactic energies are coming in because it makes it different.
Yeah.
And it's funny how we start off chit-chatting on the topic, and then suddenly it's like really powerful.
Yeah.
So
always fun to play.
Yeah, I made a note today that I somehow. Not lost, but I didn't felt the space very much lately.
Mm-hmm.
So that's interesting, but that's for next time. It was more like a reminder, like, okay, where are the space fairies?
We will invite them in next time then.
Yeah, because they have the lovely, gentle, blissful, humorous energy, and that's what I really like. So yeah. It was just when I was making notes, I was like, where are the space fairies? So, well, it was beautiful again. If you want to find Inger, you go to Facebook, Inger Arnes. If you want to find me, go to my Facebook or my YouTube. If you didn't subscribe to my YouTube, please do.
Yeah.
And because then you will always see what I do, and Inger and myself are always on there as well. So if you want healing, you can ask Inger. If you want, you can ask me. You can ask Inger and myself if you find, because we have done a couple of, I think, more than three duo healings, and they were really, really profound. They were really deep, and for people with really stuck topics, we could help them in an hour much, much on the way. So. That's the advertising part, I think. If there's anything else in here.
Stay in your heart.
Yeah. Let your heart filter everything.
Back to the heart. Stand in the beam.
And see you next time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye.